Thank you, Mike Boo. Chris Embley. And Joe Pointer. The Yellow Jackets. Lovely group of musicians responsible for a great amount of product in the American scene today. Met up with an arranger by the name of Bob Kernow, or at least their music did, and he turned in a piece called Nimbus into a big band chart. We'd like to do it for you now. This is Nimbus.
Thank you.
you see it, David Lopez and David Duarte are not playing alto 1 and 2 respectively. David Lopez is out on tour, and David Duarte has stepped into the first alto chair, and we'd like to welcome to the band Steve Ray, who's taking over second. Thank you. Jazz has always stolen to survive, and that's just fun. Borrowed to survive. Sorry. Thank you. Tom Kulis is really Autumn Leaves. We're calling it tonight Autumn Greets, and we're going to feature on this John Homstad, who is going to play the bass trombone solo.
Thank you.
session.
Thank you.
The soloist, David Williams. And Sandy Sturgeon. James Perez. Jeff Marchand. We would like to close with Pete Lengel's Fat Mama's Revenge. The interesting thing about these titles are that they are products of warped minds and imagination. I know, I say it all the time, I skipped last year. The best one that I've ever heard came out of the New England Journal of Medicine. And it's perfect. I mean, you can find all kinds of good titles in medical journals. This one was Voodoo Poisoning in Buffalo, New York. Before we close, I would like to thank you for coming out tonight. The other thing I'd like to say to you is that you're all invited to an improvisation clinic at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning, right across the hall in Music 110. We have the world-renowned flutist Paul Horn, who will be here just for this period of time only. And he will spend an hour with us and giving us the Paul Horn version of improvisation. And you are all invited, and you are all invited. Anybody who would like to come. Thank you again for coming. Here is Fat Mama's Revenge. We'll be right back. Thank you. I appreciate that. As you can tell, the people on stage, they do work very hard. It's a physical, process. Not for me. This chart somehow is marked as a bebop chart. It goes way back when. But somehow the writing also lends us toward the late era of swing. So we have a kind of a crossover chart here that seems to lend itself both to late swing and bebop. The theme is carried by the alto, baritone, sax, and trumpet cut. And I think that we're just about to do it. Footprints in the Firewall. It's not quite as good as Voodoo Poisoning in Buffalo, New York, I suppose.
Jeff said, but it's better than Walk Like an Egyptian.
One, two, three.
Mm-hmm.